Ohio cops falsely accuse and harass an entire family. I have the video, I have the background, I have the context. Here it is. Okay, they are only walking. That's it, right? After school. Now, they were walking home, waiting for two of their sisters at the bus stop. This was on the 15th of February. I have more video. Here it is.
Fellas, I just walked in. Can you tell me how to talk to us, please? Because I need to talk to them.
What's the problem? They were taking my daughter from the bus.
I need to go talk to them. What's the problem? Right now. I need to talk to them. Right now.
What did they do?
They were walking in the middle of the street, and I need to talk to them. So please send them out here.
What do you mean? What did they do?
Man, this isn't up for debate. They need to come outside.
I'm not arguing with you.
You are. You have to.
I was walking on my window, and they literally crossed over.
Yeah, they crossed over in not a crosswalk. So please send them outside for me.
There is no crosswalk.
97.
Here. They're minors. Like, they literally just came this way to get my daughter from the bus. I don't know what the problem is.
Okay, well, I want to hold you.
No, well, you're going to yell at me.
Yes, because you want to sit out
no,
here.
No, because you're working with me. I'm asking what's going on. Right. They are minors.
If you shut up for 1 second, if I do a traffic stop, I have every legal right to go out with them. They run in this house. I have a legal right to speak with them.
I was down there at the bus.
All right, I'll get warrants for them. I'll get warrants.
For minors? For
minors? I don't care. What's their name?
Because you never said nothing to my child when he crossed the street. Yes, you came from this way. You literally came from this way as they were already in the yard coming up the stairs.
Told them to stop and then they ran in your house. Everything is reported.
Winter waistband. Could have had a gun. Could not have
they
had a gun.
They have t-shirts on,
stop.
Sir.
I'm not debating with you. I'm telling you what they observed, okay? If we knew they had a gun, it'd be significantly different.
Jaywalking. All of those officers came into that home, harassed that family because of alleged jaywalking. Put up the picture of the family that these cops harassed. Three 16-year-old boys walked home after waiting for two of their sisters at a bus stop on the 15th of February. This is in Lorain, Ohio. When they returned home, police tried to question them for, and I quote, looking suspicious. Their mother, her name is Mary. Mary refused to send her son Jordan outside when police said he and his friends were jaywalking. Mary says she was afraid to send her son outside because he has dreadlocks, as you can see. She says she believed the police were profiling him and his friends for their appearance. You actually hear them acknowledge this in the video. They wanted us to fall back. They didn't want us to play the video online. Police Chief James McCann wasn't happy. He said his officers did no wrong. He agreed with what they said, but I said, that's not fair. Right is right and wrong is wrong. Badge or no badge. Mary Hildreth is her name, was charged with misdemeanor obstruction. She was charged with a crime. Obstruction of who? A cop. She says her attorney says she did nothing illegal. Now the paperwork there. Let me give you the police chief right now. His name is James McCann. All right. Does he look like a guy that protects the rights of citizens? He's the Lorain, Ohio police chief. His office did not respond to Indisputable's emails or calls. However, his department did put out a video justifying the charges against Mary Hildreth, the mother, and attempting to link the teens to a shooting last year on their block. Insane. Here's a shooting that occurred on the same street in June last year. Here it is. All right. In the release, which shows Hildreth House is in a high crime community, the police said one of the teens yelled, "Oh, ish." It's the boys, meaning police, before going into the house. That was not audible in any of the videos. Let's put this up, the complaint form. Complaint forms are typically available via online with many police departments, just an FYI. Joseph says his son and nephew had nothing to do with that shooting between local gang members last year. He says there are gangs in the area, but his son and nephew don't participate. They have no criminal record. Mary Hildreth filed a complaint with the Lorain Police Department on the 23rd of February. The complaint reads in part, "The kids were already entering the house as the police got out of their car and yelled to come here. So I proceeded to ask for a supervisor. The supervisors basically agreed with the officers that the boys looked suspicious," which, by the way, is the very reason she did not send out the child with dreadlocks. Because she said, "I think they are targeting him for how he looks." When Joseph and Mary Hildreth met with the chief, they say the chief did not offer to drop the charges and said he would have returned with a warrant. But jaywalking, if you feel like there's a gun in our house, write us a ticket for jaywalking and leave. Go get a warrant. And we'll let you, my son and his friends, went straight to the bus stop. The thing is, they wear the big rhinestone belt buckles and all that. They sag, they wear hoodies. And we're not going to tell him that he can't wear something. I'm not going to yell at him, tell him to keep pulling his pants up. I'm not going through that fight, Joseph Hildreth, the father said. Now, Joseph says he worries local gangs may think his family is gang affiliated and may become the target of a shooting. Well, why would he think that? Because the police chief, to cover the activity of his own cops, basically insinuated that they were involved in the gang. That's why the cops have now put them in additional danger. Joseph set up a GoFundMe. Let's put it up. And if you are able, I encourage you to contribute. They need help finding an attorney because of the harassment. So, all of this over jaywalking. Jaywalking. What was it really about? Ego. This was not about law and order. This was not about protocol and policing. This was not about keeping the community safe. This was about ego. Now, ego has permeated to a dynamic in the court that must be justified by those who are paid to protect the same community. You realize everyone that they're harassing in part pays their salary. Literally, they are paying for their own oppression at this point. We wanted to bring light to this story. We are looking for the police chief to now give us a response as we are seeking additional information about the officers who were involved. All right, let's put that GoFundMe out again. Let's put it up again. Please make sure you contribute if you are able to. That's the information to the GoFundMe. All right, they need help finding a lawyer. All right, David, thoughts?
I think that police chief is not going to come out with a statement that confirms he is a tyrant, but he is in fact a tyrant and his department is full of them. Seven police officers had to respond to this. And again, as the mom knows, if this was so compelling, they could have gone to a court and gotten a warrant to come in. But the moment that the mom said, "No, you need to get off my property," police are required by the Constitution to leave. They have to leave. And the fact that they did not leave and continue to harass this woman and her family shows just what tyrants they are. Secondly, there is a concept known as hot pursuit, and that is if somebody commits a violent crime or an armed robbery or a shooting and runs into the house, yes, under those circumstances, police can run into the house after that person, but you can't justify hot pursuit because of a jaywalking citation or problem. It just doesn't work. And so this woman's charges are going to get thrown out. I hope she brings a lawsuit against this police department because they need to be taught a lesson that the Constitution still matters.
Very well said. Very well said.